What is the time for the fuel savings to justify the higher price that you pay for a hybrid? So we're going to do the calculation in Google Sheets, and you can use Excel as well, and figure that out. And I'll show you where to get all the data for your variables and what you can change in your model. If you have different assumptions, let's say your gas price might be changing, or the price of the vehicles, or the mileage that you drive, that could all impact the model. And at the end, I will also show you where you can do the same thing on this website, that you can plug in the information and will give you the same result to figure out the break-even point. However, I like to have everything in Google Sheets so I can run different models and different examples, and you can save it on your drive. So let's get started. So the vehicle that we're going to use for our example is going to be Toyota RAV4. It's a very popular vehicle, and they have a gas model as well as hybrid model, so it's a perfect example. Now let's find the price for the vehicle. So you could use Kelley Book, and it has the information for a lot of vehicles. However, I found that that price was very low. It was more manufacturer's price. It was not a true indicator of what really dealers are charging, what they want you to pay. So I found some other information on some other website, and you can use a variety of sources, and all the links I'll place in the notes. And most of the time when I looked at this information is that the gas vehicles were about 2,000 or 3,000 less than hybrid models. So we're kind of going to go with that. And one more website that was very helpful, and that's what we're going to be using, is the fueleconomy.gov. And I really like this option here that they have where you can compare different models. So the way to do it, if you go to the fueleconomy.gov, and if you go to under find car, compare side by side, you can specify a year, a model, and you can compare them side by side. And like in our case, we have the hybrid and we have the gas vehicle Toyota RAV4, and we have some pricing information here. So for the gas, it's about the highest, it's about $36,875. So we're going to use like $37,000. And for the hybrid, we're going to do $2,000 more. And here we also have the miles per gallon, and these numbers are averages. So for example, for the gas, it's 28. That's a combined city and highway. And maybe you're just using your vehicle locally, so you can use the city or highway number. And for the hybrid, we also have the combined rate, miles per gallon versus city and highway. And again, I'm just going to use the combined rate for our model. So we have 37,000 that we would pay for the gas vehicle versus 39,000 for our hybrid. Now, what is the difference? We would take the hybrid price, subtract the gas price to find the difference. Now, what else do we need? Now we need the average miles per gallon. And from our compare side by side information, again, we have the 28 for the gas vehicle and 40 for the hybrid. So we have 28 miles per gallon for the gas and 40 for the hybrid. Okay, now what else do we need? Now we need to figure out how many miles per year do we drive. You can do the calculation yourself, or you can use some statistics that I found on this website. The average miles driven by Americans is about 14,000. Now, depending on your state, it varies. So the smaller state, the more condensed ones, they have fewer miles you drive. For Illinois, for my state, it's 12,000. And it also depends on your family situation, but some vast states like Wyoming, the average is 24,000. So it's a huge difference. So we, you know, you can use that average, or you can just calculate for your specific situation. Let's say you bought a car, and right now you bought the car 10 years ago. And right now the car has 100,000 miles. So how many miles per year do you drive? You take the total miles on your car divided by the years to get how many you get in a year. And, you know, obviously the situation can change, but that's what we're going to be using right now. You could have 120,000 on your car right now, and maybe it's 7 years. And so on. So you can see, you can adjust this information. We're going just to go with the 10,000 just to keep it simple right now. Now, what else do we need? Well, now we want to figure out how many gallons of gasoline do we use if we have the gas vehicle versus the hybrid. So I know I'm driving 10,000 miles a year. And I know for my gas vehicle, from 1 gallon, I can drive 28 miles. So to figure out how many gallons of gasoline I need, I take the 10,000 and divide by the 28. So I will need 357 gallons of gasoline in order to drive the 10,000 miles if I have the gas vehicle. Now, what about for the hybrid? If I take the 10,000 and divide by 40, because from each gallon of gasoline, I can do 40 miles, I need 250 gallons of gasoline. What else do we need? We need to figure out the price of 1 gallon of gasoline. Here I found some average gas prices, and for 2022, I took an average of this data, and it's about $5.41, so $5.41. Now, again, you might live in a city where it's more expensive, maybe $6, $7, you can put that in. Maybe you live in an area where it's actually less expensive, so you can put that information here as well. So that's the average gasoline price in 2022 right now in the US. Now, how much do I spend on gas if I have the gas model? So I would take the 541, which is gallon of gasoline, the average, multiply by how many gallons of gasoline I need per year, 357. So I would spend $1,932 a year to drive the 10,000 miles if I have the gas vehicles. Now, what about if I have a hybrid? I would take the $5.41 per gasoline times, I just need 250 gallons of gas for the hybrid because it burns less gas per more miles. So that's why I'm getting this $1,353 that I would spend. So what's the saving? If I spend $1,932 for gas versus hybrid $1,353, I can subtract one from the other to get my savings of $580. So that means if I have the gas vehicle, I spend $580 a year more than if I have the hybrid. Okay, that's great, but I did spend $2,000 more on the vehicle. So I need to calculate how many years will it take for the break even point for me to recoup the $2,000. So what you want to do is you take the $2,000 and you divide it by the yearly annual savings of 580 to figure out how many years it will take. It will take me 3.5 years before the break even points. That means if I spend the $2,000 right now on the hybrid, it will take me 3.5 years to recoup it, that amount, because I'll be saving 580 every year on gas. Now let me show you a calculator online that does the same thing. I put the 10,000 miles I drive a year, 541 per gallon of gasoline as an average price, 28 miles per gallon I get for the gas vehicle, the price was 37,000. Hybrid was 40 miles per gallon average, and 39,000 was the price. And again, it gives you the 3.5 years. You can run the scenarios here. You can maybe save it as a screenshot and so on, but I like having everything in Google Sheets or Excel because I can run the scenarios here. Because the situation for a family might be different. Maybe you actually drive, 15,000 miles a year. So in that case, it will take you less to recoup the extra price. Or maybe you drive so much, but the price increased to your area it's $7 a gallon. So you see, it takes even less. Now, what about if you just drive locally? You don't really drive much. You drive 5,000 miles a year, and maybe the price in your area is $5. So then it will take you much longer. So you can see it depends on your family situation, and depends if you expect to keep the car for 10 years versus if you're expecting to sell it and so on. So you want to run these scenarios for yourself and figure it out. How much you drive a year? What's the gas price in your area? What's the price really of the vehicle? Which models you're thinking of? And so on. So hopefully you found this helpful. Thanks so much for watching.